Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note 2 and 3 YouTube channel, and today I want to show you the Find My Mobile website by Samsung. It is a website that you could use if you ever happen to lose your Galaxy Note 3 or your S4. I don't think it works with your Galaxy Note 2 though. For your Galaxy Note 2 or any other Android, you could use the Google Play's Android Device Manager. I did a whole video on this for the Galaxy Note 2 series, but one catch with the Google Play's Android Device Manager is that you have to have it pre-enabled, and if you've lost your phone and you forgot to enable it or you didn't know about it, well, you're out of luck. The Find My Mobile website is different, fortunately. You don't have to enable it before you lose your phone, you could just use it. So let's start by logging in. Log in with your Samsung account. So on the left side, you could see there are a lot of options here. And if you have more than one Galaxy device, make sure you have the right one chosen. And you could see it is checking to see if it has communication with the device, and online means that it is able to talk to your device because your device has an internet connection. And if you're wondering, no, you cannot use any of these features if your phone is turned off. We just don't have the technology for that yet. So let's look at all these options here. One, locate my mobile. When you click on it, it might take a couple of seconds. And you can see that it found me. I have zoomed out a little bit just for my privacy. And another thing you may have noticed is that on the Galaxy Note 3, you get this notification. And just in case somebody has taken your phone on purpose, maybe you don't want to do locate my mobile first. You may first want to lock your phone. Now, when you're locking your phone, you can set a message to display at the lock screen that you're going to set. And you could also set a phone number here. This phone number serves many functions. One of the functions is when you get a text message on your Galaxy Note 3, it will forward it to this number. It will also update you on some of the progress changes. For example, if somebody inserts a new SIM card, you will get a message to this number that you specify. And I'm going to type in the phone number for this Galaxy S4 here just to show you what it looks like. Okay, you could see that the phone is locked. You could see the message that you set, and you could type in the PIN here, and you could see that we got a text message here. And it says, lost phone locked by Samsung Security Service. And now that the phone is locked, you can now do some of these features like locate my mobile and maybe start tracking as well. So I do want to mention that all these features will be great if you've accidentally misplaced your phone. For example, at your friend's house or at the library or at the mall, and somebody has turned it in and they wouldn't mind returning it to you once they find the owner. But it's not going to be that good if somebody has actually taken your phone on purpose. Next, I want to show you unlock my screen. So my phone is currently locked because I locked it with Lock My Mobile by setting a PIN. What we did was we just changed the lock screen with that PIN combination. But this thing can unlock anything. If you set a pattern lock and you just can't for the life of you remember, you could just bypass that here with unlock my screen. So you could see that it went through your lock screen and I got a pop-up message here saying that my lock screen has changed. So if you want to protect your device, you have to set that screen lock again. Let's try ring my mobile. And for this, I want to turn off the sound here. I'll just put it on vibrate. And let's see what happens. Okay, there you go. It displayed this message here, and even if my phone was set on vibrate, you could see that it played a sound. Okay, message forwarding, we kind of already covered. It just forwards your text messages that you received on your lost phone to the number that you specify. Call logs, so you could retrieve the call logs on your phone. And the last one, wipe my mobile. One is you could wipe the external memory, and then you could also wipe the internal memory by doing a factory data reset. You have to agree to the terms and conditions, and you have to type in your Samsung password and then hit wipe. So anyway, that's a quick look at Find My Mobile by Samsung. I think it is a step up from the Android Device Manager, and it is especially better because you don't have to have remembered to turn this feature on before losing your phone. So for more videos on the Galaxy Note 2 and 3, make sure you check out my YouTube channel and make sure you subscribe for more upcoming videos. Once again, thank you for watching.